Hello, my name is Drew Pickles and today I am going to Gatti Land. For those who don't know what Gatti Land is a pizza joint slash arcade a la Chuck E. Cheese. The main difference being that Chuck E. Cheese serves pizza to you by the pie, while Gatti Land is a buffet and it was a place Earthrealm's dad always took him to when he was really little, but when he was 8, it closed down and was bought by some stupid bridal boutique that sold dresses for disgusting females and is now a store that sells scooters for hand bones. So anyway, when I get to Gatti Land there will be an extremely long line which will consist of Puerto Ricans, Mexicans, Jamaicans, Indians and Orientals, and I will wait for as long as it takes for a butthurt Star Wars fanboy to cry about how The Last Jedi is the worst Star Wars movie ever before I rate the long line like Earthrealm also went to PJ's as a kid. He can't remember which he enjoyed. So I will get to the cashier and order a shit-stuffed crust pizza with girdled bovine ejaculation as the cheese, Ronald McDonald's anal blood, instead of pizza sauce and instead of pepperoni I will ask for Charlie Sheen's AIDS-infected cock cut up into small slices. And the pimply-faced cashier who is the twin brother of the pimply-faced team from Aladdin's castle will say, "Sir, we don't have any girdled bovine ejaculation. We don't have any anal blood. Let alone anal blood that comes from a Q-list celebrity such as Ronald McDonald, better known as the Penis Clown. And last but not least, we absolutely do not and will not cut up a man's penis, especially an AIDS-infected one. Especially not one of a celebrity as beloved as Charlie Sheen. Charlie Sheen is one of the most selfless, clean-minded people in Hollywood. He respects women and treats his body like a temple, and I will laugh out loud like J.K. Simmons did in Spider-Man 2 and then ask you serious and he will open his mouth to answer, and that is when I will proceed to shove my 300-mile-long cock down his throat like joy. I am making that sound because I let some of my cum. And since the Down syndrome cashier is useless to me, I will have to assemble this pizza all by myself. So I will go to the Barney Bunch mansion and collect Mr. Bucket and then pull vault over to an Amish farm and I will see an Amish guy working with a cow and I will say, "Good day to you, sir. I was just noticing that you were about to milk that cow when there is actually a sweller way." And the Amish guy will ask how, and I will run over to the bull and start beating its cock off, and the Amish guy will say, "Sir, that's not a cow, that's a bull," and I will say, "I know, this is how we milk bulls in Drew Land," and he will say, "Get off my land right now, you sick fuck," and the bull will ejaculate into Mr. Bucket like swas 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 swas. It will take time for this milk to curdle. Swas 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 swas. The bull will then get very angry and shut his horn off my ass like that Mexican bullfighter, and the pain will be so swell like boy. And I will rate the bull like Mr. Bucket will then take the bovine ejaculation back to Gatti Land, and I will realize I forgot to rate the Amish guy who called me a sick fuck, so I will rate him like using all your stupid Amish bullshit and still this. The next stop is the workplace of Ronald McDonald, better known as Penis Clown. So I will arrive at McDonald's and there will be another ridiculously long line consisting of white trash with their stupid camouflage clothing, ghetto rats who are always late for work and never pay their bills and are pissed off at the stupid grandma of their dysfunctional families, Chinese people who don't fucking speak any English and instead talk in their chin-chon talk, stupid morbidly obese Latino girls who talk loudly on their cell phones in their stupid butchered dialects while trying to be as aggressive and obnoxious as humanly possible, Africans who talk in clicking noises, red man Indians who blame their people's suffering in the white man without knowing what specific tribe they are, sand niggers and their four wives and many sand nigger children, and as always I will wait for as long as it takes for mindless Ben Shapiro worshipper to call something they don't like SJW, before I rape all the males in the line like the Muslims in Earthrealm's town actually don't have that many kids, but the Mexican thing is absolutely true. It's because Guadalupe doesn't want them to. Use condoms. Am I to play a video game that isn't fees? Am I to? Why are Latino girls so fat, loud, and obnoxious? Am I to smacking them all together with my cock like smack, 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 smack? You must know what I am talking about. Smack, 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 smack. You must be desperate to date a girl like that. Smack, 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 smack. And I will get to the front of the line and see Ronald standing behind the counter, and I will point and laugh at him and say, fa 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 fa, you're working fa 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 fa. People with jobs are losers. Fa 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 fa. And I will tell him that I am making a pizza that requires his anal blood, and Ronald will show me a barbed pair of anguish that he is trying to keep away from the pube muppet so he can't get satisfaction. So I will take the pair and shut it up his ass and turn the key like turn. There is a cease and turn, catching the blood in one of the Speakonia Battle of the Bands promo cups. Turn. The one I am holding is of the sick pulpies. Turn. The cause the song maybe was obviously written by gay faggots. And then Ronald McDonald will say that of all the things he thought might happen while working at one of the thousands of restaurants he checks up on, he didn't expect the Spanish Inquisition. And then suddenly the Spanish Inquisition will bust down the doors and one of them will say,
Inquisition.
And the lead Spanish Inquisition guy will tell one of the other Spanish Inquisition guys to read the charges, and the other Spanish Inquisition guy will read the charges, which are listed as sodomy, blasphemy, offensive fashion choices, and dishonoring the Pope. The lead Spanish Inquisition guy will then tell the third Spanish Inquisition guy to bring in the Spanish donkey, but instead of a wooden ledge mounted in legs, it is a literal donkey that speaks Spanish. The Spanish donkey will say, "Hola, amigo, my amo el bro," and I will say, "Wait a minute, this is a Drew Pickles video. You're not supposed to speak actual Spanish," and the Spanish donkey will science a adjunct go cooking on Mahandra Dionair 0 and Brabu 1 to left square bracket 0. You want home carrot darmok at jellard at anagrast kate rq 3 h f los jagnt paul h c q j c g g slash kismarakad all c u 8 q m g dag coin rukid gogor beon coidramug and Ronald McDonald, and I will rape the Spanish donkey in the ass like am I shutting all the members of the Spanish Inquisition of power asses. And then we will shut out the Spanish Inquisition, and they will be turned gay by our magic butthole mucus, and they will be wearing pink instead of red, and then we will proceed to have an orgy with the Spanish donkey like and then we will make the Spanish donkey an honorary Barney Bunch member and the Spanish Inquisition members as gay toilet slaves. Then we will place the anal blood of Ronald Phoenix Clown McDonald in a glass dildus and shove the dildus up the Spanish donkey's ass and tell him to meet up with Mr. Bucket at Gatti Land. Our final stop will be Charlie Sheen's house. When Ronald and I get to Charlie Sheen's house, I will ring the doorbell and he will not answer, so I will ring again and he will not answer, so I will ring again and he will not answer, so I will ring again and he will not answer, so I will ring again and he will not answer, so I will ring again and he will not answer, so I will ring again and then he will answer in nothing but a towel and he will say, "Sorry, I was in the bathroom listening to myself gargling," and I will use every single ounce of my willpower to hold my cup in my pants and say, "Hello, my name is Drew Pickles and I am a Hollywood producer and we want you to be in a movie for us," and Charlie Sheen will say that he doesn't have time to be in a movie with us, and we will say, "That's okay, we'll just ask Kevin Sorbo to do it," and we will pretend to walk away and he will scream, "What? You want that actor Spad to be in your movie? I'll do it. I'll do it for half the price you were going to pay, Sorbo." So we will go to a Hollywood studio that has been fitted to look like an old sawmill, and Charlie Sheen will ask what the fuck kind of movie this is, and I will say, "That is a very good question," and the reason that is a good question is because if someone is going to be in a movie, he should know what kind of movie it is, and the reason someone should know what kind of movie he is in is because then they can give a better performance. I will then answer that this is a very scary horror movie being made by Rob Zombie. Charlie Sheen will then ask where Rob Zombie is, and Ronald will say that Rob Zombie is very shy, and that we are his proxies. Then all of a sudden Barney the triple testicle dinosaur will come out in a wig, and we will tell Charlie Sheen that he will be acting opposite Jennifer Lawrence, and Charlie Sheen will buy it and ask what his motivation is, and I will tell him that a psychopath played by Bruce Campbell has tied his girlfriend to a lug in a sawmill, and the only way to save her is to cut his penis up like a stick of pepperoni, and Charlie Sheen will ask where Bruce Campbell is, and we will tell him that he is busy doing Bruce Campbell stuff, and that we are going to shoot the Bruce Campbell parts later and splice them into the film, and Charlie Sheen will pull his dick out and put it on a cutting board and ask where the cameras are, and I will say the cameras are invisible, and Charlie Sheen will just shrug his shoulders and will start cutting his dick up like cut. That was easy. Cut. He probably thinks dicks grow back or something. Cut. I mean, they do for swell faggots, but we don't know if Charlie Sheen is swell enough. Cut. And then Charlie Sheen will ask when the movie comes out, and we will say that it will come out when all scary movies come out in January. So I will take the pieces of Charlie Sheen's dick, and then I will remember seeing him in a towel, so I will rate him like Welcome to Hollywood. Using all the props as dildos. Fucking the hole where your dick used to be. The swash. That was swelling. Now after 9 minutes of shenanigans, we will return to Gatti Land. Once we are back at Gatti Land, I will once again make my order and tell the pimply-faced teenager that we have all the ingredients, and the pimply-faced team will say, what the fuck? We just had a conversation about this. I am not making that disgusting pizza for you, you sick fucks, and I will then say the line. Say it with me. I will now show you the true definition of a sick fuck, as I rate him like and then we will prepare the pizza. First I will make the pizza dough by using the yeast from Barney's urethral yeast infection. Then I will dice canned tomatoes and mix them in with Ronald McDonald's anal blood, and then spread it on the dough in which I have shaped into a penis. At this point, the bovine ejaculation will have gurgled, and I will grab it from Mr. Bucket in globs and place it in the sauce like a margarita pizza, just like it is actually prepared in Italy. Then I will take the pieces of Charlie Sheen and arrange it on the pizza also in the shape of a penis. Once I am finished, I will set the oven to 690 degrees and put it in and wait for it to bake like wait. What's the difference between a Jew and a pizza? Wait. A Jew actually saves you money. Wait. And once the pizza is done, we will sit down to eat it, but first we will say grace. I will say, dear Lord, we thank you for this swell meal with blood and cum on it. We also thank you for the dildos and for giving us assholes to pleasure them with. We also thank you for it. Someone in the adjacent table will say, sir, what you are doing is very offensive, and that, as a white Protestant middle-class man who makes $100,000 a year, I feel persecuted by homosexuals having human rights, and I will just rate him like Barney, Ronald McDonald, Mr. Bucket, and the Spanish donkey are forcing a stupid white picket fence family to watch. We are not taking turns hang raping the stupid what? Once the stupid 80s sitcom family is gone, we will command the air the big TV and turn in some gay porn. This specific gay porn is an 8-hour shot of George Takei and Neil Patrick Harris raping the holy shit out of Shane Harper, and we will all masturbate to it like some stupid soccer mom will storm over to us and scream that she was bringing her son to this place for his birthday party, and they were watching The Land Before Time 3,263,827 before we changed it to this disgusting faggotry that is traumatizing them, and I will simply say to the stupid overbearing single mother that I have something that will traumatize them even more, as we all ejaculate on her and the stupid birthday party like and the cum will land in the stupid fat mom, and all the stupid children and James Gunn will be conveniently at the next table and will make a funny tweet about this and will be immediately accused of being a pedophile, and Mickey Mouse will walk up to him and give him an X, and then James Gunn will chiss Mickey with the axe and cut him up just like Mickey did with the broom in The Sorcerer's Apprentice. Then a bunch of brooms will hoist James Gunn up in his shoulders like a sultan, and they will carry him off to shoot an all-broom remake of Guardians of the Galaxy. When we are done with our pizza, we will then proceed to the arcade. Once we are in the arcade, Barney and I will go over to the Swamp Stomp Machine, and the Swamp Stomp Machine will say welcome to the International Swamp Olympics featuring Hopping Harry and Jumping Jack. I will play as Hopping Harry, and Ronald will be Jumping Jack, and just like the DTR game at Aladdin's Castle, Ronald and I will use our bell sacks to push the buttons, and the cartoon frogs will go out. Meanwhile, Mr. Bucket will be at the spin to win game, and the machine will say spin to I, and Mr. Bucket will pop his balls out of his mouth, which are actually the severed testicles of James Rolfe and Mike Mattei, and the balls will get stuck in the machine, and the machine will say ball jam, and Mr. Bucket will say no, this is a fucking ball jam, and Mr. Bucket will break the machine open and suck in all the blue rubber balls and pop them out of the top of his bucket. Then Mr. Bucket will overhear the Spanish donkey say I. No es bueno, and he will go over to the Spanish donkey at the Cyclone game, and Mr. Bucket will ask what is wrong, and the Spanish donkey will explain that the Cyclone game won't land in the winning white despite his time being perfect, and Mr. Bucket will say what the funk? What the funk? What the funk? You could speak English the whole time. And the Spanish donkey will explain that he can't, and that he isn't even from a Spanish-speaking country, and that he is actually from Illinois, and the Spanish thing is for the sake of the pun. Mr. Bucket will give a fuck for 3 seconds and then explain that the machine is rigged, and there is only one surefire way to beat the machine, and Mr. Bucket will suck up all the balls in the floor, including the severed balls of James and Mike, and then suck up the balls, and then will go Super Saiyan and fire balls of ultimate swell energy at the machine, breaking it open and letting all the tickets out. Mr. Bucket and the Spanish donkey will then meet up with Ronald and I at the prize counter, and we will ask where Barney went, and just like the devil, Barney will appear, and I will ask Barney where the fuck he went, and he will explain that he was at the skee-ball game using his 3 testicles as the balls and beating Blue from Foster's home for imaginary friends and winning all his tickets. He will then pull a massive ball of tickets out of his ass and the prize counter, and I will ask what kind of prizes we want, and we will all unanimously agree with our homosexual telepathic powers that we want to buy the Estes model rocket so we can ignite it and let it launch up our asses, and the prize counter, and I will ask what the fuck is wrong with you Pritz? Why would you take a toy that was made to inspire children and use it for such a perverted way? Why would you openly admit that to me? I don't want to hear that. Nobody wants to hear that, you sick fucks, and all of us will say in unison. We shall now show you the true definition of sick fucks, as we all rate him like and then the manager will step into the arcade and ask what the fuck is going on here. What happened to the cyclone machine? What happened to the spin to win machine? Why do the swamp stomp and skee ball machines smell like balls? And we will say we just wanted to redeem our pool tickets for the rocket to launch up our asses, and the manager will say, wait a minute. Aren't you going to see you were just turning Gatti Land into Swelly Land? And I will respond, yes, but we already did that and you were on your lunch break. The manager will then tell us to just take the stupid rocket and get out of the establishment, and then he will walk out. Barney will scream, no. You are supposed to call us sick fucks, and I will say, wait a minute. Why do we need the manager to call us sick fucks? And Mr. Bucket will simply say, I don't know, and we will all exchange glances and then rush the manager and rate him like the Mr. Bucket is sucking on the manager's balls and dethroning him, while the Spanish donkey fucks him with his donkey bit and goes assle chicken fc ball sd j knoilerns mob mazum j g ball q b m r g ball m g r q slash more musk g r m j r m glen glens bams boom bam. Barney is smashing the manager's back with his balls, and Ronald McDonald is stepping on the manager's dick. And then we will steal all the prizes and go back to Drewland. Wow. That sounds so very super clafferdelistus expil as well. I think I will go to Gattyland right now. See you later, my gay faggots.